Hi guys, and welcome to another Divi theme video. This is Jamie from System22 and webdesignandtechtips.com. Well, we're looking at a fantastic plugin today. It's called Divi WowCarousel. It allows you to make all kind of carousels. We've got a simple image carousel going on here, but you can make carousels with products, with blog modules, with content. We've covered these in the past before, but today we're just going to make this simple image carousel with a little caption and a little description down the bottom there. Really easy to do, so let's get started. First thing I'm going to do is enable my Visual Builder. And once enabled, I'm going to go down and delete this module here. I've just got a little section with a row with two columns in it. Obviously, you can make this whatever size you want. It'll fit into any column size that you wish. So I'm going to add a new module. And if we roll down here, here are our carousels, and we've got card carousels, content carousels, Google review carousels, image carousels, which I'm going to use today, logo carousels, post carousels, product carousels, smart sliders, team carousels, testimonial, and Twitter feeds. And honestly, there's some fantastic stuff today. Like I say, we're going to do simple image carousel today. And here it is. First thing it's going to do is prompt us to add a new item. Before I do that, because I'm using a small space here, I only want to display one at a time because it lets you choose how many you can display like a regular carousel. So I'm going to go into the carousel settings. I'm going to leave everything as it is for the time being. Slides to show. I'm just going to make that to one. So our slide will fill out the available space there. Okay, now let's go back up and add a new item. I'm going to add the image. There it is right there. Now below you've got alt text, title and subtitle. Alt text should always really be used for a description. Don't know if that's a sunrise or a sunset. I'm going to call it a sunrise. A lot of people use this for keywords. Not really that effective, but you can do it if you want. And geolocation data for Google Local Pack. But it really should be used for descriptions. For people that use screen readers that are sight impaired, it'll read out what it actually is. And let's say Blue Mountains at sunrise, the description. We'll just say mountains at sunrise. So we've got a title, description, and an alt text in there. And as you can see, the title and description has turned up over here. If we roll down a bit, we've got something called tab content. Now I'll put some stuff in here, but you won't see it until I actually enable that. And we're not going to use this today, but I will demonstrate it. So let's put in the title. And for expediency, I'll use the same thing as I used before. Subtitle. In fact, I'll say tab so we can know the difference. You can add a little image if you want to. A little thumbnail image. Like I say, you won't see this, but I'll show you what it does in a moment. So just remember, we've added a little image and a title and a subtitle. Okay, moving on down, we've got a link. If you want to link your images to somewhere, obviously put your link in here. Usual thing with best practices, if you're linking to your own site, leave it in the same window. If you're linking off-site, open it in a new tab so your site stays open. You can add a background color below. I don't believe I'm going to add a background color to this at the moment. At the moment, you wouldn't see it anyway because our image is covering the whole of the background there. Yep. Okay, let's move on to our design tab here. And you can actually set a fixed height for the image. You can get some crazy effects going on by doing that. That's a nice little feature. I don't want to do that today. I'm going to leave it at its original aspect ratio. Image hover animation. You've got a lot to choose from here. I'm just going to use a zoom in. As you can see, it kind of zooms in while I'm doing that. You can add an overlay color or a gradient. And I'm sure you know what an overlay does. If I just quickly put a color in there, I don't think I'm going to keep an overlay, but I'll demonstrate it. I'll bring the opacity down. That just makes it darker. And you can add an icon. As you can see, the icon's in the middle there. And for your content, you can choose how wide the content is, where it is. I'm going to put mine absolute, but I'm going to put it at the bottom, horizontal position. I think I want to put it in the center. And we'll do that with the text in a minute. I'm going to put it on the bottom. It's dark on dark, so you can't see that at the moment. We can add a background color. Let's roll on down to the text and actually put that in the middle, title and subtitle. Let's make it white so we can see it at first. There's our title. Let's put it in the middle. And our subtitle. If we roll back up, we'll make that white. And we'll put it in the middle also. Now if we go back up to our content, we can give our content a background color or a gradient if you prefer. Let's add a black. And we got that little separation at the bottom. Again, I'm going to take the opacity down a bit. So it's there, but we should be able to see a bit of an image behind it, especially when we change this image. And I'm going to take off the overlay and the icon there for this particular thing. I really don't feel that I need it. I just wanted to demonstrate that for you. So I'll just take that background color away. And we'll get rid of that icon. There we go. So we've got what I need there. Okay, so we've done our little text there. Don't really want to put a border around it. Don't want to change any spacing or put any box shadow on there. Filters transform. That's fine. So let's just save this. It'll take us back to the regular tab right there. And if we roll down a bit, you've got the carousel settings we briefly touched on. Here's our animation speed. This is the time it's going to take to flip from one to the other. The actual time it'll slide from one to the other, that is. And the autoplay speed is how long it stays on each one. We'll change that in a minute when we put some more slides in. You can choose to add navigation, which are the arrows, pagination, which are little dots underneath, or both. I think I'll just add a little bit of pagination. Now we've only got one, so it's not going to show up yet. If you've got different width slides, you can put fixed width on there. Number of slides to show, we looked at that earlier, and I'll flip that in a minute when we've got more slides just to show you the difference. Again, spacing between the slides, that's irrelevant at the moment. And spacing, I do want it to infinitely loop. If you turn that off, it'll stop when it gets to the last one. Now here's what I was talking about earlier, the tab settings. Remember, we put in a little image, a title and a subtitle. If we go in there, flip this to on. Suddenly we've got a tab down underneath. And for me at the moment, we don't really need that, but that's a nice little feature to have, especially if you've got information that you're talking about for your image. And you can choose to show subtitle, title, and the thumbnail if you want. If I switch that on, we should have that image of that young lady. There it is. And again, that's a nice little feature. You can change the spacing. And over in the design, of course, you can change tab style and elements. And like I say, that's a nice little feature. We're not going to use it today, but I wanted to demonstrate that for you because it just shows the versatility of this little carousel right here. Okay, well, let's go back in there and we'll turn the tab off again. And I'm fairly happy with everything on our first slide, so let's duplicate and just add a few more slides. Simply going to hit the clone button to add a couple more slides. And remember, they're only sliding one at a time. There's the pagination. It showed up now that we've added more slides. So we'll go in and we'll flip the pictures around. We'll just go in there and change the text on these ones. I won't do the alt text on these. And I'll save that one. And let's go into our next one. Quickly flip the picture on that one. And we'll change. And we'll leave that like that. Great. Well, as you can see, we've got that. We've got our zoom effect. It's changing. And if we save this now, go back into our carousel settings. Let's change that animation speed, the time it flips from one to the other. I'm going to bring that up to about 2 seconds will do. It's quite slow. And it'll stay on each one for, say, 4 seconds, 4,000 milliseconds. You can slide. You can select it and just type in a value. And you can increment with these little up and down arrows to the right there. So it'll stay on each one for 4 seconds. It'll take 2 seconds to slide from one to the other. Spacing in between, I actually don't want any spacing, a little white gap there. Let's have them actually attached to each other. There we go, I like that a little bit better. So we're in good shape there. Now if I was to flip this and show different amount of slides, you've got some advanced ones here as well where you can do the transition. Ease in and ease out works well for me. They're all slightly different and some will work better in some circumstances than others, but it works for me. Lazy loading, that's great for speeding up your page load time. I've got swipe enabled, so that'll work on a tablet or a mobile too. You can give it an auto height. I don't really need that for this today. And it's going to scroll things one at a time. You can turn on vertical mode if you've got a carousel with more than one image and they'll be on top of each other rather than left and right. Center mode will put one in the middle. Now I'll just flip over the amount of slides that we've got here. If I go back to the general, I flip that to 2. As you can see, we've now just got 2. And we could put a bit of spacing back in there if you wanted multiples. Of course, this will work better with a bit of space when you've got multiples. Put in whatever space you want there. And if we go to our advanced now, I can put it on vertical mode. And as you see, it's doing it vertically, which is great there. Center mode is if I had 3 or an odd number. Well, I can put it on center mode and all it does is make sure that there's one in the middle right there, but that's not really going to work for me today. And vertical mode, so let's flip it back to how it was. And we're good to go. Let's save our changes. We'll save the page changes down here. Save draft or publish if you're ready. And exit the Visual Builder. And there we go. And that's one of the many things you can do with the WOW Carousel. Like I say, that's a simple image slider. It alone has got many options. But when you add all the others with blog posts and things like that, the WOW Carousel really is one of the best carousel plugins I've ever come across. So there you go, guys. I hope you've enjoyed this today and found it useful. If you have, please give it a thumbs up, comment, share, and subscribe to our YouTube channel. Once again, this has been Jamie with System22 and webdesignandtechtips.com. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.